We met on Twitter. Right after Dre's album came out, I saw he messaged me, and I was like, oh shit, Mac Miller just hit me. And then I look at the message, he's like, yo, congrats, man, being on Dre's album, this and that. It must be crazy. I was like, man, you know how it is, dude. It's crazy, this and that. And then he responded, he's like, no, I don't know how it is to be on Dre's album, but congrats. And I was like, I'll fuck with this dude. And then we just kept chopping it up after that. My favorite thing besides his smile and his laugh and just like overall energy was just how smart and quick-witted he was, you know? Like a lot of people, like they get the impression that maybe he was this like breezy kind of stoner guy, but he was so smart and quick with it. You know what I'm saying? Like he knew his musicians, he knew all these songs, and he was quick with the jokes. We were always roasting each other, and it's like had that energy that it was like magnetic and was no ego. He had probably done the most touring, made the most money, and at any given time in the room, you know, probably had, you know, the most going on. I didn't know he had all these crazy things going on with him. Right after we did the dang video, he checked in the rehab, but you would have never been able to tell. He was just always having a ball. But he always found the comedic relief in everything, you know. He was just like that dude, and one of the dudes that you can always hit and you always pick up, you know, no matter what. He was always up, which was going on. He was with it.